You already know what Newt Gingrich can do for poor children.
What if they cleaned out the bathrooms and what if they mopped the floors?
Oh, that's a grand plan. I'm all for it. Get them working young, you know. This country needs servants. I need servants. I need new servants. Ones I have are stealing my gin.
But what if you're not a child? Or black? What if you're rich? What can Newt do for you?
Just a minute. Old man, I've never worked a day in my life. I earned my money the old-fashioned way. I inherited it and then sheltered it in offshore accounts. Certainly not going to start working now.
You don't have to. Newt has a plan for you that doesn't involve work. And it's already done wonders for others.
You can make an argument that I helped Mitt Romney get to be rich.
That's right. Newt's amazing Romney plan for rich clientele enables you to actually make money by eliminating other people's jobs. Just listen to this satisfied customer.
Corporations are people, my friend.
Darling, look, it's Mitt Romney. You remember Mitt from by the pool down at the club. Rather odd bathing suit. By Joe, that's his secret, huh?
That's it. Newt Gingrich has a plan for everyone. If you're rich, he'll make you richer.
Oh, very good.
If you're poor, he'll make you scrub toilets. Either way, rich people win. Call Newt today.
Yes, but first make us another old-fashioned.
Clients must provide two bathrooms.
This time make it the old-fashioned way.
Idiots. This game show that's passing for a Republican primary has got to stop. I mean, it is just getting out of control. You got Donald Trump in there, you know, because money talks and everybody else can just sit and wait to see, what it buys. It is the most amazing, bizarre world thing I've ever seen in my entire life. And here you have a president of the United States saying you need to stay at work through Christmas if you cannot get a payroll tax deduction to the American people, because it worked. The economy is in an uptick. We had 3% GDP last quarter. We had 1.28 million jobs created in the last 4 months. With this payroll tax holiday, people are spending more money. Consumers are driving the economy again. 70% of all activity in our GDP number is consumers doing what we do, buy stuff. And it's working. And I don't want to see this recovery be brought to a screeching halt. So pass this freaking thing. Pay for it. I suggest a surtax on every dollar over $1 million that's earned next year to pay for it. But you're not leaving Washington until you get it done. Now, you know what's really interesting is last year it was the same crap. Same crap. I remember being lectured to by the whiny John Kyle. And last year the holdup was the START treaty, swear to God. The START treaty with Russia, the nuclear weapons treaty, the START treaty. And healthcare for the 9/11 first responders. And the Republicans kept saying no to both. Well, of course, the START treaty passed 71-26, right? But they were just making a big to-do out of nothing. And the 9/11 first responders bill passed. It became legislation. But it was, of course, idiot boy Senator Tom Coburn, who's on the freaking TV right now with facial hair. What is the epidemic of facial hair? What is that? Who said that a goatee was the way to go, Coburn?